Hey guys, this is David from Omega Engineering. We got a lot of questions about Wheatstone Bridge circuits and how they're used with strain gauges. So don't strain your brain, hang tight, and we'll break it down for you right here. A strain gauge by itself acts like a variable resistor whose value changes when the strain gauge sees deflection or deformation. But since strain-induced resistance changes are extremely small, the best way to capture those changes is by using a Wheatstone bridge circuit, where we can capture the change in resistance as a function of change in voltage. So, here's how it works. So here we have a simple diagram of a Wheatstone bridge circuit consisting of one power source, three precision resistors, namely R1, R2, and R3, and one variable resistor, namely RG, which also acts as your strain gauge. Now, when you measure the voltage between point B and the negative side of your power source, and point D and the negative side of your power source, if they are the same, it means that you have a balanced Wheatstone bridge. Now, to have a balanced bridge, the ratio of R1 over R3 should be exactly equal to the ratio of R2 over RG. Now, since RG is your variable resistor indicated by your strain gauge, any change in resistance in RG will throw the bridge out of balance. And the voltage that is measured across points B and D is directly proportional to the change in resistance that the strain gauge sees. And that's exactly how you can measure the change in strain by measuring the voltage output coming from your bridge. So there you have it, folks. Hopefully we have decoded the mystery of the Wheatstone bridge. Stay tuned for the next video where we will be putting this theory into action. And if you need more help on pressure, strain, or force measurement, feel free to contact one of our engineering experts at omega.com. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe.